right. I cleared it.
It seems you've become more of a man.
Hey, why did you bother to teach me all that anyway?
I suppose I was feeling whimsical.
Thank you.
guess I should break. I'll register for the first round of the tournament at the arena counter. Since Syllabus and Gaspard can't come with me, it'll be Adelie and myself. Yeah.
Haseo, your character is different somehow, isn't it?
It's a job extension. It won't make up for not having a third person, but it should help with our chances for victory.
Let's do our best! much longer now.
Mm.
The spectator seats are filled up. It really feels different when you're about to fight an official match in front of an audience.
Mm.
Can we win? What do you think, Haseo?
Adelie.
Yes? What?
Calm down.
Okay. I'm sorry. I wonder if Syllabus and Gaspard will come to watch us.
They will. I'm sure. So, gotta put on a fight we won't be ashamed of.
I'll do my best!
The match is about to start!
Hmm, so he did forfeit the match after all. I'm surprised. He's got more guts than I figured. Didn't think he'd get a job extension.
The moment you've been waiting for, it's the first round of the Demon Palace Tournament! Today's commentator is... We're pleased to have Kestrel's Guildmaster, Mr. Gobby, here!
Ha! Perfect weather for a picnic.
Now then, what do you think will be the highlight for the upcoming match? How long do you think the newcomer, Team Haseo, can last against Team Bordeaux?
Today's Bordeaux is a very good woman.
Anyway, it seems that Team Haseo is already down by one.
Was that it?
Take that!
Die!
Damn it. Is this the end?
Hey now, little Haseo. What's wrong? You're finished already? Come on, let's go! What's the matter? Try and say something, huh?
No. I can't be finished. They're all counting on me. If I lose here, then I won't be able to protect anyone. Not Syllabus. Not Gaspard. Not Adelie. Not Shino! I swear. I am going to kill you with my own hands! And Endrance? And Tri-Edge?
I have found you!
Come to me. Come on!
do this.
Stop right now! Haseo!
Say goodbye.
he did it! The winner is Haseo! It's a miracle! What an unbelievable attack! I have no idea how to describe what just happened! This must be disappointing for you as Kestrel's Guildmaster. Any comment?
Is it over already?
The match was decided in an instant! Now that it's come to this, we would love to see him fight against the Emperor!
I'm Gabi!
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Well then, farewell!
Welcome to the world.
Hey, Kun, how was that? Did you see? That's right, I finally got my avatar.
You idiot! Do you have any idea at all just how dangerous it is to use an avatar against a human player?
Hey, you know what they've done just as well as I do. It's their own fault. They deserved what they got.
They deserved it? It's their own fault? Come on! Do you honestly believe that? If you had made one wrong move out there, they could have easily ended up in a coma. What is wrong with you? Don't tell me. Don't tell me you.
Shut up already. They woke up from the attack, right? So everything's fine.
That's not the point!
Give it up, Kun. As far as he is concerned, an avatar is nothing more than a useful tool.
Oh? What else do you call it, then?
Listen to me, Haseo. The power we Epitaph users possess is a power that has deviated from the system of the world. If we use it with no control, the world's rules will end up wrecked. That's why Epitaph users should never, ever use avatars. Except against things like Ida!
Well, too bad for you that I'm not a good little boy like you. I use whatever powers I have to their full extent. That is my way.
Don't you get it? What you're saying, what you're doing, is the same as the nonsense those hackers spout!
Thank you so much for the lecture. But I'm going to use my avatar however I like and whenever I like. Hacker, if that's what you want to call me, fine. But I have no intention of changing how I play this game.
Haseo! Damn it.
I told you.
Hmm?
He's not fit to be an Epitaph user.
with the online Jack crew near the home of Michiru Tajima, fourth grade teacher at a school where six students were struck down by doll syndrome. Let's continue our in-your-face investigation.
This is Salvador Aihara. Here I am, reporting from the residence of a female teacher. Samba, samba! Well, here I go. Help! Fire!
Oh no, a fire! Where?
Good morning, senorita!
Huh?
Truly a sight that could chill a 100-year passion.
Ah! Why are you filming?
So tell me, the six children who contracted doll syndrome, had they been playing the online game called The World?
Well, they did get together and talk about an online game a lot.
And what are your plans right now?
I'm going to the Kawaguchi residence.
Osamu Kawaguchi? That's one of the six students who have been resting at home due to doll syndrome.
How could you possibly know that information?
Now we shall make our way to the Kawaguchi household, where one of the victims of this barbaric illness is being treated.
You're not coming. And stop following me.
Wait!
Not here.
It's summer vacation. Maybe he's on a trip.
But I told him I was going to visit him.
Huh? The meter's spinning like crazy, which means someone is definitely in there. Hello? It's me, Salvador Aihara, born in Brazil, raised in Saitama, friend to lonely housewives.
Hey, don't do that! You don't have the right to just barge into someone else's home!
But I'm sure everyone at home watching this wants to know what's really going on, right?
Huh?
I want to know! Even if we do break a few laws, he's the man of truth! That's Salvador! Hey, I hear something up there!
Huh? Osamu?
Last night, a middle school student lost consciousness while playing.
The U.S. Army's new combat robot, Talos, is the perfect robot soldier. Its movement is controlled remotely, and it's armed with a machine gun as well as a 40-millimeter grenade launcher. But more importantly, it has no fear, no family, and does not suffer any emotional stress.
Thank you.
right there. I'm sorry to keep you waiting, Sakaki.
Guess I'll stop by Kennard's at home.
You came! Thank you!
Haseo! Oh, Haseo! You were so cool! You were amazing!
Get off me! Hey!
Congratulations!
Congratulations, Haseo! And, I'm really sorry.
Why are you apologizing?
Well, I mean, we didn't do anything.
We just left everything up to you. Sorry about that.
Come on, you guys, cut it out. Get your heads up. I just did what anyone else would have done. I mean, after all, I am Kennard's guildmaster. It's my job.
Really? So you mean that you're not mad at us?
Don't make me repeat myself.
Are you okay with us? Is there anything we can do to help out?
Yeah! Can I help too?
Do what you want.
Thank you.
is calling me. Yada's calling me.
It seems that you have awakened, and you are now able to use your avatar.
Huh. Some aren't so happy with that.
Don't worry about Kun.
And are you okay with that too, old hag?
I will obey Master Yada.
Well, you sure are dedicated.
You would never understand.
Now, shall we get on about your mission? You are to investigate the area of my designation and to attain a sample of the first level Ida. Now, do you have any questions?
How do you get it?
By using the Avatar's data drain, you can also draw out Ida's data.
Hey, you haven't forgotten what you said when you asked me to join GU, have you?
I have absolutely no qualms about rendering assistance to you in your search for Tri-Edge. Watch.
Well, not bad. Where do you want to go next?
I want to go eat something.
Okay, then maybe we should go back now.
What is this?
It's a record of an accident. An accident that happened about a month ago in the world.
What? Is he a PK? Hey, this doesn't look good, guys. Let's get out of here.
Run!
This is the same thing that happened to Shino.
Due to the shock the victim suffered from the attack, he is in a coma and has yet to recover.
You mean there are others like Shino out there?
We have a name for the players who have fallen into comas. We like to call them the Lost Ones.
The Lost Ones? What is he? An Epitaph user?
The only thing we know is he's not a regular player. Upon researching the access record for the area, we have found information that matches the three victims, as well as one other unknown player ID, which is suspected to be Tri-Edge. Those records remain on the logs. However, the entry record for the Chaos Gate in the same time period of the attack you just watched shows only three players.
In other words, he's getting into areas through means other than a Chaos Gate?
Yes, he sure fits the description of a ghost.
So, how the hell do we track down someone like that?
If we find out anything else, I'll definitely let you know. In exchange...
You want me to investigate Ida, right? Okay, fine. I'll do it.
Very good. I will notify you of your area of investigation later. You are dismissed.
Man and Terrence. What does he want? Old Man and Terrence. What does he want? He's a